In this video, I am going to show you how to install Google Analytics on your website. What is Google Analytics? Google Analytics allows us to track who is coming to our website, how they are coming to our website, and more importantly, what are they doing on our website. Knowing these basic metrics is the basis of every successful website. And it blows my mind that some people have had websites for years, but they haven't even heard of Google Analytics. Basically, having a website without Google Analytics is actually pointless because you've got a website just for the sake of having a website. You have no way of tracking what is happening on your website. And ultimately, we want our websites to work for us. And if we don't know what's happening on our website, then how can it actually work for us? My name is Mohammed Asmal. I am a digital marketing strategist. Let me show you how to install Google Analytics on your website. Now, in a previous video, I showed you how to install Google Tag Manager. So in this instance, we are actually going to install Google Analytics via Google Tag Manager. So let's go to our screen and I'll show you how to do it step by step. So the first thing we want to do is go to analytics.google.com. You can just search for Google Analytics and you'll see the first option that shows up will be analytics.google.com. So when I click on it, it's actually going to open up Google Analytics. You may not have it, so you'll actually have to sign up. So you'll see something like a sign up sign or a login sign. All you have to do is just log in. So because I already have Google Analytics installed, my dashboard will look something like this. But all you have to do is just click on create an account or sign up. Here I will choose dev website. Just gonna write dev website because I'm installing Google Analytics on a test website. And here I can actually choose whether I want them to share my data with them. Then click on next. Property details, again I'm going to choose dev website. And then I'm going to choose South Africa. I'm in South Africa. And the currency, although we don't need it, but it's good just to set it, I'm going to choose South African Rand. And now here, very important, before we click next, we have to click on show advanced options. Why? Because here is going to allow us the option to install Universal Analytics. So what is Universal Analytics? Basically, Google Universal Analytics is an older version of Google Analytics. Last year, Google Analytics came out with a new version, which is called Google Analytics 4. Although it's a newer version, it still has some features that are missing, which you have in Google Analytics Universal version. So ideally, we want to install both. And there's no harm in installing both because it'll give us valuable metrics. And going forward, we will have both versions installed on our website. So here we want to tick this, create a Universal Analytics property. And now we want to add our URL. So let me just get the URL. And this is HTTP, but you actually can use HTTPS. Because this is a test domain, I haven't installed an SSL certificate, but you want to install an SSL certificate. And here it's asking us, create both a Google Analytics 4 and a Universal Analytics property. We want that to be ticked because we want to create both. We don't want only a Universal Analytics property. So once we've got that sorted, we click on next. Now here we can add our industry first. So because this is a test site, I'm just going to add anything, but you guys can choose what you want. And then business size, we can choose how many employees we have. And then it's going to ask us, how do we intend using Google Analytics? So we want to measure customer engagement with my site or app. Yes. Optimize my site or app experience. Yes. Measure data across multiple devices or platforms. Yes. Optimize my advertising cost. Yes. Increase my conversions. Yes. Measure content monetization. This is not an e-commerce site, but if it was an e-commerce site, you will tick that. Analyze my online sales. Again, you'll tick that if it is an e-commerce site. Measure app install. This is not an app. Measure lead generation, yes. And then we click on create. Now we have to accept the terms of service. So you can go through this and read it. Click on accept. And now it's creating our Google Analytics account. So now initially it is installing Google Analytics 4. So this is very important. This is telling us our stream URL, our stream name, and our measurement ID. This is very important. So I'm going to copy this. And now I'm going to go into Google Tag Manager. Remember, I told you how to install Google Tag Manager in a previous video. I'll have the video linked in the description if you want to find that. I'm going to go to Google Tag Manager. We're going to find the instance dev site. This is the one. So click on it. And I've got no tags. You can see zero tags, no tags, no workspaces. So I'm going to click on tags. And click on new and untitled tag. So here you want to name your tag. This is very important. So we can just name it something like GA4. And then I like to add my tracking code next to it so I know which one it's for. And then tag configuration. This is GA4 configuration. So I'm going to click on that. Measurement ID. This is the ID that we want. We can get from here. So I'm going to install that here. You can leave everything as normal. And the triggering, when do we want it to trigger? We want it to trigger on all pages. So click all pages and then we click on save. And just like that, Google Analytics 4 is installed on our website. But we still have to submit it, but I'm going to submit it all at once. So the next thing we want to do now is we want to install Universal Analytics, because now we've installed Google Analytics 4. Now we want to install Universal Analytics. So from here, we're going to click on new. And here we'll call it GA Universal. And here I'll go back to my Google Analytics account. And here you can see GA1 is showing GA4. The other one is showing dev website. I'll go to this one because this is my Universal Analytics account. And from here, this dashboard, I'm going to go to admin in the bottom left. Then I'm going to click on property settings. And I can get my ID from here. Or I can go to tracking info and I will get the same info there. I can get tracking code and I can get it from here. Right, so both ways you can get it. I'm just going to copy this now and I'm going to go back to Google Tag Manager. I'm going to just add it in the name so I know which one it's for. And click on tag configuration. And this one is Universal Analytics. So I'm going to choose Universal Analytics. Page view, we leave that as normal. Then here it says select settings variable. So when we click it, you'll see we don't have any variable. So we will have to create one. So I'll click on new variable. And this one, I'm going to name it the same tracking code. And here I'm going to add the tracking ID. And I'm going to click on save. So once this is saved, you'll see it'll pick up there. And then I'm going to go leave everything else as normal. Then we'll click on triggering. And here again, we want to choose all pages. And then we're going to click on save. So just like that, now I have installed both Google Universal Analytics and GA4. But before we do this, one important step is we must click on submit, because now we've added these tags, but we have not submitted it. So basically submit is like save. So I'm going to click on submit and then we can add a name. I'm going to say install GA, stands for Google Analytics. I'm going to click here, Google Analytics installation. We can name it whatever we want. And I'm going to click on publish. So now this is basically going to save the changes that we have made. So it's telling us now we have two tags. Now let's test to see if the Google Analytics is actually working. So how we can do this is in Google Universal Analytics, it'll be easier to track. In Google Analytics 4, it takes sometime up to 24 hours for any stats to start showing up. So let's just go to Google Analytics, which is the one that I suggest that you use more until Google Analytics 4 becomes more stable. So it's saying right now we've got zero people on the site. So all I will do is just refresh this page. And now, as you can see, it's showing one. So that means one person is on the site. And if we go back to our incognito mode and let's go to, say, sample page. This is the standard page that comes with WordPress install. And now if I go back to Google Analytics, and as you can see here now, it shows sample page. So now we know that it is working. So why do we want Google Analytics on our site? Remember I mentioned earlier what stats it can give us? Let me just show you quickly a brief summary of what it can actually show us. All right, so I'm just going to show you a client's website. And as you can see now on this side, it's saying that three people are currently on the site. And it'll even tell us what pages they are on the site. The main stats that you want to focus on are real time. You're not really worried about that. Audience, because this is going to tell us how many people have come to the site. Now here it's saying 2,226 users, but let's just go, because this is giving us for the last 7 days. Let's just say last 30 days. Click on apply. I think for the last 30 days, 10,725 people came to the site, 12,773 sessions, 1.19 sessions per user, pages sessions. Basically, it's telling us that on average, people visited 2.4 pages on our website. Page views, there was over 30,000 page views. Average session duration, this is very important. People have spent an average of 2 minutes and 54 seconds on the website. That tells us that they liked what they saw on the website. That's why they stayed for so long. Obviously, if someone didn't like the website, they won't even stay longer than 30 seconds. So that's very good. Bounce rate, anything under 40% is very good. This is saying 6.29, which is actually excellent, but I don't think that is very accurate. But more important is to know how much time they are spending on the site. Then from here, just briefly, we can go, we can even see country. It'll tell us which countries people are visiting our site from. Obviously, because this is a South African website, majority is coming from South Africa. We can even go to city. It tell us exactly what cities. If you want to see more cities, we can click on view full report and it'll show us more cities. We can even see browser, operating system. I'm just going over this quickly. Then the next important thing is, now we know how many people came to our website. We want to know how did they come to our website. Then we go to acquisition overview. This will tell us exactly how did these 10,725 people, how did they come to the website. So it's telling us now 9,810 came from organic search, 853 direct. That means they typed in your website like test.co.za and came here. Referral, that means someone has sent them to this website from their website. Social means they came from social media. Email means they came from email. So even if you click on social, it'll actually show us which platforms. So you can see 30 came from LinkedIn, 4 from Facebook, 4 from Twitter. So quickly, that's an overview of how people come to the website. The next important metric is, what are they doing on your website? So now we know how many people came to our website. We know how they came to our website. Now we want to know, what are they doing on the website? So this will tell us exactly which are the most visited pages on our website. So for example, it's saying this page had 6,320 page views. And then from here, what we can even go, if we go to behavior flow, this will actually show us like a step-by-step guide. So for example, it's saying like this was the most visited page on the website. They came in from here, then 169 went to the home page. From there, 38 went to another article, and another article, you can add more steps and see people actually what they did step-by-step. Like they came in from this point and where they went to next and where they went to next. This was a brief overview of what stats you can view in Google Analytics. But this tutorial was more to show you how to install Google Analytics on your website. So I hope you found this video useful. And until the next time, keep on untangling the web.